the question states, he actually says, I'm torn between the love of my imams and the disunity amongst the ummah. Did the imams of the Ahlul Bayt curse the Sahaba openly? Do we have narrations and plenty of them, or is it just few where the imams of Ahlul Bayt openly cursed the bad Sahaba?
Yes, actually, we do. We do such a hadith. And I mentioned some of them in my series called Tahrir al-Insan al-Shi'i.
The Liberation of the Shia.
Yes. One of them was after the martyrdom of our Holy Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam spoke out openly about those people and he cursed them. في المسجد النبوي الشريف.
In the mosque of the Holy Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Also he wrote a كتب كتابا.
He also wrote or sent a letter.
أي لأبي بكر لعنه الله.
To directed to addressing Abu Bakr.
وذكر فيه ما يجرحه بالطغيان وما شاكل علنا. ذكر فيه ما يجرح أبا بكر ويصفه بالطغيان وما شاكل بشكل علني.
And he wrote to him that which asperses him and criticizes him severely in a known and public way.
وحتى المخالفون يقرون بطبيعة الحال أنه علي عليه السلام كما في رواية مسلم وغيره أنه كان يصرح بكونهما ظالمين فاجرين خائنين غادرين إلى آخره.
And they themselves, the Bakri individuals, those who refer to themselves as Sunnis, as a denomination, as a sect, admit and acknowledge the fact that Imam Ali, blessings be upon him, criticized Abu Bakr and Umar and considered them to be treacherous, sinful, liars, oppressors, as it is reported in Tariq al-Madina by Ibn Shabba and
Sahih Muslim.
And Sahih Muslim, of course.
وكذلك يقرون مثلا بأنه عليه السلام وصف عثمان علنا بأنه حمال الخطايا.
As do they admit and acknowledge the fact that Imam Ali, blessings be upon him, declared Uthman to be the carrier of sins.
وأما عندنا فلا يعد ولا يحصى منها مثلا خطبة الوسيلة التي كانت بعد تولي أمير المؤمنين عليه السلام الحكم بأسبوع واحد.
As for the narrations in our corpus, then they are uncountable, such as the sermon, the known sermon of Khutbatul Wasila by Imam Ali, blessings be upon him, that was declared only a week after the martyrdom of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
وفيها جرح أبا بكر وعمر وثم تلتها خطب وخطب كانت صريحة علنية مدونة في مصادرنا منها قوله إن عثمان كفر ثلاث كفرات وغدر ثلاث غدرات.
And after that particular sermon, many sermons followed up where Imam Ali, blessings be upon him, openly condemned and aspersed the likes of Abu Bakr and Umar and Uthman, and in a specific one where Imam Ali, blessings be upon him, said that Uthman has disbelieved with three mighty actions of disbelief, and he committed three mighty actions of oppression. ثلاثة فجر
غدرات
غدرات three mighty actions of treachery.
وفي دلائل الإمامة مثلا نقرأ أن الإمام الصادق عليه السلام لما جاءه قوم من المخالفين من أهل البصرة يسألونه عن عائشة فقد وطلحة والزبير عراهم وفضحهم وقال إن عائشة عظيم إثمها كبير جرمها وكذا إلى آخره.
And in the narration stipulated or mentioned in the book of Dala'il al-Imama by al-Tabari, where a group of the Basran individuals visited the Imam, Imam Sadiq, blessings be upon him.
They were from the Mukhalifin.
And they were from the, of course, Shia. the Bakri individuals, non-Shia, asking the Imam, blessings be upon him, about his opinion regarding Aisha, Talha and Zubayr, the people of the camel. And the Imam, blessings be upon him, said that Aisha's crime is indeed huge. عظيم جرمها كبير إثمها. And her sin is very great. And there is no, shall I continue the hadith?
Yes. Yeah.
And there is no blood that was shed on that day, except that it is in her neck and in the neck of her two companions.
وهذا الأمر سبب صدمة نفسية عظيمة لهؤلاء المخالفين فقالوا إنك جئتنا بكلام لا نحتمله.
And this matter was of significant surprise to the questioners who asked the Imam, blessings be upon him, and said that this is a matter that we can't handle.
فقال لهم وما طويت عنكم أكثر.
Then the Imam, blessings be upon him, said and stated that what I have concealed from you is even greater than that which I have revealed.
وكثير من هذه الأحاديث اللاعنة أو الطاعنة على هؤلاء المنافقين من أصحاب النبي صلى الله عليه وآله وزوجاته كذلك.
And many of these narrations and ahadith that are stipulating and stating clearly, explicitly, damnation and curses, aspersions towards these hypocrites.
والتي كانت علنية أيضا.
And that which were public and known.
أحصاها أو عددها العلامة الكبير خليفة المرتضى في زمان أبو الصلاح الحلبي في كتابه تقريب المعارف.
Was mentioned and counted and accumulated by the successor of المرتضى, الشريف المرتضى, known as العلامة الحلبي or الحلبي.
أبو الصلاح.
أبو الصلاح الحلبي in his book تقريب المعارف.
اللهم صل على محمد.